So subukan natin i-arangkada ng konti. Oh.
Now that extra length means additional pieces of metal, longer propeller shaft, etc. And that resulted to an additional weight of 110 kilograms, about 2 average weight Pinoys. With the additional weight, is the engine tuned for a little bit more power?
Wow! Definitely, maganda ang suspension nito, nagbago.
Pogi, guwapo, maporma, cute. I think we can all agree that the Jimny is one good-looking car. Regardless of our age group, when we see a Jimny on the road, beside our parking, when we go to the mall, sa parking lot, when we walk, it's a head-turner, di ba? But the question is, does it lead you to buy one? Well, if you are a college student and your daddy can afford, then yeah. If you are a young professional, still single, and you have an outdoor or very active lifestyle, yes, go ahead. Or if you are in your mid-40s, mid-50s, or you are retiring and you just want to have a toy car and you can afford it, yes. But for the average, for most of us, average income family, like me, I probably can afford a second car, but I cannot afford a toy car that will just sit there on weekdays and I'm just gonna play with it on the weekends. If I am going to buy a second car, it will still be a car that can be used by the family, right? So, nandun pa rin yung practicality. So, one example, like I mentioned, when I was looking for a car for my daughter who's going into college, yeah, most of the time, it will be hers. Most of the time, she will be the one using it. Pero, there's still a big consideration of that second car should still be applicable for us as a family to use it, like, for example, during coding days. So like the four of us and a few luggages should still be able to fit comfortably. So like I mentioned during our first test drive and first review of the Jimny, the three-door. Yes, maganda, pogi, but will I buy it? Parang alangan eh. No, kasi bitin. Eto, this time, Suzuki released a five-door. It just changes everything. Okay, may five doors na kayo. Nice. Wow, let me take a look again. Di ba? Iko-consider mo na mas seryoso ka na ngayon to look at this model with the intention of buying. Kasi yun yung parang hinahanap mo dun sa three doors eh.
So today we are here at Suzuki Auto Makati and we will have the opportunity to test drive the new Jimny 5-door. This particular model is the top of the line GLX 1.5-liter 2-tone 4-speed automatic in sizzling red metallic with bluish black pearl top. Before we do the test drive, we will check the exterior design and some of the features inside the vehicle. The most interesting feature of the new 5-door Jimny is the second row seats. And the very first question is, how did they modify the existing 3-door to make way for the 2 additional doors, right? Because you must have already observed that they look pretty much the same except for the extra doors. The overall length of the new 5 doors is 3,820 millimeters. It is 340 millimeters or 13.38 inches longer than the 3 doors. Which part of the 3 doors was modified for that extra 340 millimeters? If you look at the wheelbase, the 5 doors is exactly 340 millimeters longer. Now take a closer look of the rear wheel going to the rear bumper. They are the same. That tells us that the entire 340 millimeter extra length went to the wheelbase since nothing was changed at the rear, right? The boot was not made longer. Now that extra length means additional pieces of metal, longer propeller shaft, etc. And that resulted to an additional weight of 110 kilograms, about 2 average weight Pinoys. With the additional weight, is the engine tuned for a little bit more power? Is the suspension tuned to manage the extra 110 kilograms? The overall width is 1,645 millimeters, the same as the 3 doors, while the overall height is 1,725 millimeters. It is slightly shorter by 5 millimeters. Probably that's just a difference in the tire profile. The ground clearance is 210 millimeters, the same as the 3 doors. Now, the turning radius is 5.7 meters. It is 0.8 meters wider. And that is expected because of the longer wheelbase. Now, let's check the front fascia. It is basically the same as the three doors. It's still having the iconic 5-slot front grille and round headlamps with manual leveling device. For the GLX variant, you have an LED projector equipped with individual washers to help ensure bright illumination even when diving in mud and dirt. And then of course, there's your turn signal and halogen fog lamps. The engine of the Jimny 5 doors is the 1.5-liter K15B, 4-cylinder, 16 valves, the same engine as the three doors. Even the power output is the same at 102 PS and 130 Newton meters of torque, matched with the same 4-speed automatic transmission. So that answers the question. No modification made in the engine for that additional weight of 110 kilograms. But do you really need to do so? It's just like driving around with two additional passengers, right? What are your thoughts? Here's the key, nothing fancy, two buttons for unlock and lock. When you press unlock, you get two flashes. When you press lock, you get one flash. It's not a flip key and there's no push start button. Okay, let's get inside. It's all plastic here on the inside of the door. The texture feels rugged and easy to clean. The typical control buttons for the power windows and side mirrors are not here. Aside from the tight space, probably the reason for moving them inside the cabin is to protect the electronics from water, mud, and dirt.
So that's why yung mga controls ng window niya is right here. So andito for the driver's side, which is automatic up and down, and then ito naman for the passenger side. Ayan. And then since this is the 5-door, meron na siya dito. So this is the handbrake, and dito yung control mo for the rear windows. And this is to turn it off. So this is the GLX top of the line, ano? And then yung driver's seat is manual adjust. Then here, the material is fabric, which is also nice. And comfortable naman siyang upuan. And even yung sa likod, yung sandala niya, the bolsters are nice. It feels comfortable. It's not very fancy, pero it serves the purpose. It's comfortable. It's nice to drive. I mean, it feels good sitting on it. So yeah, like I said, it's a regular key. Hindi siya push button. So there's the instrument cluster. And there's your infotainment. So here's your power side mirror control, right, left, side mirror auto fold. And then meron ka ditong headlight leveler, which is very useful when you go off-roading, kasi you go through different terrains and different incline. Yung tapon ng headlight mo would be way off sa on the road that you want to see. So very useful yan. And then meron dito, what's this? This is the washer. And then ito yung parking sensor. Okay, you can turn it on or off. Importante din yan, because if you are going to put accessories at the back, let's say kabit ka ng trailer, kabit ka ng mga bike rack or extra sa tow hitch mo, mag-iingay yan. So it's this one really functional, very useful to for para sa mga off-road na cars. And then there's your aircon vent. This is plastic. Ang ganda ng combination nito. It's also plastic pero different design, different texture. And then you now have this, I call this as the floating or the hanging infotainment system. Ang ganda ng design. It matches the overall look of the dashboard. And then ito, this one makes it really sporty. The first time I saw this kind of design is from a Pajero 1996-95. It seems that yung mga off-road design ng mga SUV and cars, parang naging standard na nila to. Kasi nga naman, if you're a passenger, tapos you go off-roading, tapos yung car mo goes, you know, kung ano-anong angle ng terrain na pupuntahan nyo. So you really need extra something to grip on. And then they call it the, ito meron ka rin dito na grab handle. Some people call it the OSB. Alam nyo kung anong OSB? It's the oh shit bar. Like, oh shit! We're gonna crash! So hawak ka dyan. Then meron ka ditong small lang na switch for the power window for the driver's side, and then meron ka ditong control to turn on and off the traction, hill descent control, and control power window control for the passenger side. Type A USB port here, power supply 12 volts, and then you have a small compartment here for your cell phone for the four-wheel drive. So you have 2H, 4H, and 4L. And again, your manual handbrake. Allocation for extra switches for probably for additional accessories. Pwede mo ilagay dyan yung mga switch. And then, meron ditong dalawang small cup holders. Alright? So, nakakatuwa yung controls ng AC niya. So, sorry guys, yung previous kasi na vlog that we did with the manual, yung 3-door, about 2 months ago. Hindi ko actually masyadong naipakita sa inyo yung features. Hindi pa ako masyadong familiar. So, ngayon ko lang nakikita to. I'm not sure kung available na to dun sa previous model. But, yeah, nakakatuwa lang kasi ito. Like, this is the controller for the AC fan, right? So, meron kong front and rear defogger. And then, nakakatuwa kasi yung ito, akala ko it's something that you can also turn and you can push. Hindi pala, display lang pala yan, parang clock. Nakakatuwa. So ayan, so if you want to keep the, so ito yung recirculation button mo, pag pinindot mo yan, ayan, so dun ka lang titingin. So hindi mo siya dito makikita. Okay, wala siya dito sa infotainment mo. Dito lang talaga sa maliit na display na to. Na nakakatuwa, very intuitive din naman, and naisip nilang mapagsama-sama dito lahat. So, for example, pinindot mo yung mode. This is basically yung flow ng aircon, 'di ba? So ayan, so straight to your face and down to your feet. Ayan, sa feet mo lang. And then feet mo, and then part of it sa windshield, sa may dashboard. And then back to just your face. Nakakatawa. And then ayan, AC to turn on and off the compressor. So pag pinindot mo yan, hindi na yan lalamig. Blower lang yan. And then to completely, and then to adjust the temperature, ayan. To the left, it gets colder, that's the lowest. And then to the right, to make it warmer. And then to turn it off, ayan. Nakakatawa, nandiyan lahat. So, reverse, and then there's your reverse camera. So when it comes to the steering wheel, masarap yung feeling nito. It's kind of rubber na parang leather yung feeling niya. But during the test drive, medyo nahirapan ng konti kasi medyo slippery, madulas. So, siguro mas maganda kung medyo binago nila yung texture nito, or you as the owner or the user, pwede mo siguro, I think one of the things that uunahin mong i-upgrade dito is this one, medyo madulas. And then there's your call buttons, and then meron siyang cruise control, and ayan, and then there's your volume control for the infotainment. Up here you have this beige bato or gray, the typical headliner. So ayan, and then your visor, meron kang mirror pero walang ilaw. And then sa passenger side, meron ka ring visor and wala ring ilaw. Okay, and then you have your, you know, just a simple, nothing fancy headlamp dito. Then your rear view mirror, nothing fancy. So talagang basic na pang ano to, pang off-road. And then here's the instrument cluster. You have your button here to change the display. So if you press that, there's your driving time, there's your fuel economy, average fuel economy, range, remaining distance based on your average run, estimated number of kilometers pa yan. And then your average speed, driving time. Okay, you're back to your driving time. Yung RPM. And then there's your analog speedometer. So, meron siyang kph and then meron pa rin siyang mph.
Okay, and then the steering wheel can be adjusted. So, tilt and oops, not telescopic. So, tilt lang. Okay, let's check the second row because this is really the main this is the highlight of this model, di ba? The second row seat. Still the same, maganda yung plastic dito. It looks really manly and rugged. Pero meron na siyang control dito. Okay? May control yung side mirror dito, which is nice. This is my driving position. And okay naman yung space. And then, let me move here sa second. Okay? So, okay din. Comfortable. I can say very comfortable dito ang dalawang tao of my size and maybe a little bit bigger. Again, I'm 5'6". Very noticeable pag upo mo dito is the comfortable cushion. Yung foam niya is malambot. Okay? Ayan o. So, medyo upright lang ng konti ang settings ng pagkakaupo. I don't know if this can still be moved. Ayan. Yun, nare-recline pa naman siya. Up to this point lang, hindi mo na may tutulak. Okay? So, ganyan na siya. I think it's comfortable. So, definitely, di pwede dito ang third passenger. Mahirap. Number one, aside from masikip, ito, yung seatbelt may bumabangga. Even if you lift it like that. Masakit. Hindi ka makapagpaupo dito ng third passenger. Okay? Unless tatakbo ka lang ng just a few meters, 1 to 2 kilometers, malapitan upo ng ganyan. But definitely, hindi makaka-recline. Ayan o, masakit. Buhabangga yung seatbelt. Yung buckle ng seatbelt. Okay? And then in terms of headroom, okay naman. Sakto lang. But siguro pag mga malalaking tao na, mga super tatangkad, mga 6-footer, medyo mafe-feel niya na yung height dito, but okay pa rin. And then you have a lamp here and there's no extra aircon vent, and I don't think it's necessary kasi nga maliit lang naman yung cabin, and yung the AC is powerful enough para madala na din yung lamig here at the back. So yung tailgate, yung door dito sa pinakalikod, meron siyang hydraulic assist and it actually kinda opens, you know, para akala mo nag-open siya ng automatically because of this. Nakakatuwa. So, let me close it. Bitawan mo. Ano? Yan. And considering nakababa yan. Okay, so this is the extra space that you will get. So, after the second row seat, you still have this. This amount of space. Pala ang opening niya. Yan. There's your tools for changing your tires. Okay? And then, you have a 12-volt power socket. Ayan, which is nice. And then, meron ka rin lamp dito. Nice. Okay? Now, you can still fold this if you need more cargo space. Bring this down. Fold it forward. There. You have a lot of space. Nice. Wheel size is 195/80 rim 15 Bridgestone Dweller, and the front brakes is this. And then let's see at the back you have the same size of wheels, and yun lang, the brake is drum brakes. And then of course nandito sa likod yung spare mo, and it's still the same full size.
Pagdating naman dito sa rear fender, sana nilaparan nila yung plastic ng fender dito sa ilalim, no? Para mas natakpan at mas malinis tingnan. For the suspension, you have a 3-link rigid axle with coil spring in front and the same 3-link rigid axle in the rear. All four wheels use coil springs. the same kind of suspension that you will find in the three-door version. Aside from the tool for changing tires, the Jimny also comes with extra tools like a glass hammer that you can use to break open the windows in case of emergency. Then you have a cutter that you can use to cut the seat belts. Then a pair of early warning device.
Okay guys, so eto na, nandito na tayo sa loob ng 2024 Suzuki Jimny 5 doors. 'Di ba? So magte-test drive tayo and kasama natin dito si Sir Marco Galang and nandito tayo sa Suzuki Auto Makati. So subukan natin, tingnan natin. Let's go. Okay, so ito yung top of the line 2-tone automatic transmission. Okay. Sakto lang yung manibela. Paglabas natin doon sa parking, hindi ganun kalambot, hindi rin naman ganun kabigat. Ang sarap i-drive, maliit lang siya. Ano? Sarap lang ilusot. Wow, so mas maganda ang ano ha? Mas maganda tong test drive route natin kasi may mga section na medyo rough. So na-feel ko talaga yung ano yung kung gaano matagtag ba siya, ganun ba siya ka-rough sa mga road imperfections, comfortable ba siya? Kasi nung nag-test drive tayo, maybe some of you guys have watched it. Yes sir.
Kakantay
dito. Okay. So yeah, as I was saying, last time 'di ba nag-test tayo nito yung manual during the test drive ng autofocus. Yung dinaanan nating kalye doon sa may Mall of Asia, mas smooth doon eh. So medyo hindi siya yung regular na road condition. So hindi ko, although okay din naman yung driving experience, pero hindi, syempre, you can expect mas smooth doon kasi smooth yung kalye. So this time, this is a good opportunity na dito sa Makati, this is the more realistic na road condition natin. Oh, ayun o. Oh, it's not so bad. Ayun o. So dito may lubak-lubak tayo. I don't know kung binago ba nila ang suspension tuning. Well, considering na longer to, of course, additional weight. So I can say mas komportable to. Naramdaman ko dun pa lang sa lubak na daanan namin. Ramdam ko. Kasi pareho din naman yung load ko, dalawang tao. One thing is it the suspension tuning, binago ba nila? Or is it because of the extra wheelbase? Yung extra wheelbase kasi, it will add to the comfort ng ride, di ba? Pag mas maikli kasi yung wheelbase, mas nimble and medyo matagtag. Pero ito, parang isa pa nga? Oh, ayos lang!
Sir, kaya na tayo, sir.
Oo.
Medyo masikip man dyan, sir. Pero okay. Mas okay yan kasi
oo. Sa ganitong kipot ng kalye dito, hirap na ako mag-turn dito pag yung Everest ang dala ko. So ito, maganda lang yung lusot-lusot. Definitely mas malambot ang suspension nito. 100% I'm sure of that. Tsaka mas maganda i-drive yung automatic din talaga, no? Very comfortable na. Ano oras na ngayon? It's 11:28. Mainit na sa labas and sufficient yung lamig ng aircon. Malamig. Wala namang vent diyan papunta sa likod, di ba? Okay. So kumusta ang aircon mo diyan? Kumusta? Malamig, di ba?
Oo.
So, walang problema kung aircon ang pag-uusapan, malamig. So, subukan nating i-arangkada ng konti. Oh. Mabilis din yung response, ha? Bilis umakyat ng RPM. Umabot kami agad ng 5,200. Okay, ito medyo rough ng konti dito. So, obviously, isa talaga sa mga advantages nito yung high ground clearance niya. So, dito sa area na to ng Makati, meron ditong mga, ang laki ng mga difference ng mga height ng mga roads. Eh. Kasi may mga bagong kalye dito na in-elevate na nila and then may mga old roads na nandun pa rin sa medyo mababa. Kaya marami kang ganung-ganung ganyan eh. So, wow! Definitely, magandang suspension ito, nagbago. Is it just because of the longer wheelbase kaya mas comfortable siya, or talagang iniba nila yung timpla ng suspension? Kasi kung iisipin mo, basic engineering, you have additional weight, syempre yung spring rate mo, yung suspension tuning mo, how to handle, how to manage that extra weight, will have to change. I'm just assuming na ganun nga. Driving experience, as usual, ang ganda, boxy naman siya, diba? So, yung view mo all around, very easy. Left and right, eto, tama lang yung height, hindi ka lubog. Hindi ka naman din masyadong mataas. So, sakto lang yung size for my size. Again, I'm only 5'6". Magandang view. Hindi ako masyadong nahihirapan sa pag-maneuver. Hindi ako nahirapan tumingin sa likod. Alam ko kaagad mabilisan ko anong situation all around me. Kung may sumisingit bang kamote dun sa kanan. Kita mo rin dito. And then, itest natin. Stop tayo dito mo ang konti ang tao. As usual, pakita ko lang yung paborito nating itest. Tingnan natin yung speed ng steering wheel niya. Okay, so start tayo dito. Isagad ko lang sa left. Okay, gusto tayo dito. Okay, sagad. Dito. 1, 2, 3, 4. Marami. Mga 4.5. Hanggang sa dulo. Ito na yata pinakamahabang nahawakan. Pinakamaraming turns from left to right. And I must say, medyo madulas yung ito, yung hawakan niya, no? Yung grip. I think maganda to kung lalagyan mo to ng leather wrap or ng yung aftermarket na steering wheel cover. Medyo madulas. Okay, bilis tayo ng konti. Saan nga ba tayo kakanan?
Sa may iron.
Okay, subukan natin mabilis ng konti. 40, 50, and then tingnan natin kung anong feeling ng preno. 50. Nice. Okay, yung preno. Confident, mapifeel mo yung kagat niya. Hindi siya ganun ka-abrupt. Hindi rin siya parang nag-fade. So, maganda ang brake system. Maganda ang brake feel. Okay, we're going back na. This is already our second turn. Again, uulitin ko, number one na napansin ko in comparison dun sa test drive namin last time nung 3-door na Jimny. Mas comfortable ang suspension nito. Number two, mas maganda pag automatic. Yung manual, medyo, kasi kung gagamitin mo yung sasakyan, kung gagamitin mo siya on a daily basis, at the same time, parang toy car mo siya pag weekend, I think for those two purposes, mag-automatic ka na. So, maganda. And actually, nakadi lang tayo noon. So, subukan natin mag-two. Okay. Mas may response definitely yung sa 2, mas longer yung RPM niya bago nag-change ng gear. Like I said, maraming nagagwapuan nito, maraming nagagandahan nito. Maraming nakukitan nito, pero marami pa rin sa atin na hindi talaga napapabili ng 3-door. Kasi nga parang bitin eh, 'di ba? Parang bitin. Now, this time it changes the game. It changes everything. Parang this time mas interesado ka na. Oh, may five doors na kayo. Wow. Sige nga, tingnan ko nga ulit. Sa akin 'yun ang dating eh. Kasi before, oo naman, we can all agree. Makita mo 'to sa kalye, makita mo 'to sa parking lot, kahit pa itabi mo 'to sa mga high-end na kotse, mapapalingon ka eh pag nakita mo yung Jimny. Makita mo, "Uy, ang cute noon, ang ganda." So, pero yung appreciation mo, parang okay, hanggang dun lang. Pero this time, with the 5-door, parang, sige nga, tingnan natin, baka pwede sa atin, baka applicable sa atin. Kasi, alam nyo naman yung Filipino family, di ba? Gusto natin lagi magkakasama tayo. So, bihira pa sa atin yung two-seaters lang eh. Kasi yung three doors naman, oo, may upuan sa likod, pero nagiging kargahan lang yun eh. Di ba? So, typically yung mga ganong setup, it's for the people na who can afford more. Meaning, who can buy an extra car as their toy. Di ba? Parang ganon. Or, pag yung professional ka, pwede kasi isa ka lang or yung girlfriend mo or dalawa lang kayo, so you get to enjoy life at an earlier age, so pwede ka, may budget ka for this. Pero for most of us, like me, a family man, pag bibili ako ng sasakyan, even if it's my second car or my third car, I will still consider na, oh sige, pag binili natin yan, can we use that as a coding car when all of us are together? So kung four family kayo or five members kayo of the family, po pwede ba tayo dyan? So, for a long time na naka three doors lang tayo, parang hindi mo masyadong i-consider yung jimny. Kasi nga, masikip eh, kulang eh, parang bitin. Take a look at the RAV4 as an example. Nung nag-umpisa ang RAV4, nung nilabas nilang RAV4, three doors lang din. And then eventually, naglabas sila ng five doors. Diba? So, nagkaroon na ng mas matinong, mas malaki-laki, and mas mabenta. And up to today, do you still see the three-door RAV4? Wala na. Diba? Kasi yun talaga ang demand. So, thank you so much kay Sir Marco Galang and of course kay Ma'am Flory for arranging this test drive. Maganda. If you're interested, please reach out to Ma'am Flory. Ilalagay ko dyan yung number niya sa screen. Contactin niyo siya and schedule a test drive. Mabilis lang magpa-schedule dito sa Suzuki Auto Makati. Alright? So, thank you guys for watching. Drive safe. Bye!
If you like this video, please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are also on Facebook. Please like and follow our page.